It's graduation season, and I'm so happy for all of you who are graduating this year, because finally, after so many years of studying, you've finally done it. You're getting your qualifications, and now you're ready for the big outside world that's just waiting for your contributions, waiting for your talents, waiting for your strengths, and all the value that you can bring to this world. So your next step is to find a job. For many of you, you've been doing it for some weeks already, and some of you have gotten success, you've already been accepted into your first job, and some of you are still looking for that coveted position. If you're on that road of looking for that position that will take you into adulthood, I have to say that it may not be the easiest thing in the world, may not be the best experience. In fact, sometimes it can be very lonely, it can be very overwhelming, it can also get very tedious. And so in today's video, I want to share with you 5 tips that can help you make your job search happier and more productive. Step number 1 is to celebrate the start of a new chapter. So many of us, once we graduate, are ready and rushing to look for a new job. And that's because society has pressured us. Our friends have already gotten jobs or they're in the process of their final interviews. Our parents are giving us stink eye at the corner of the room because we are at home on a weekday. And so inwardly, we're pressured to already start going on to the next chapter even before we've mentally prepared ourselves to do so. So while you're still taking these few days off and trying to review and relax, really sit down with yourself and reflect upon all the stuff that you've done in your student life and celebrate all your achievements, all your wins. And I would say a really helpful exercise for you, as well as the job search process, is to write down all the achievements that you've had over the last few years, list them down, and then look through them and remind yourself how good it was to go through those things, to learn those things, and how you can take those skills that you've learned in those experiences and use it in the future ahead. Step number 2, to acknowledge your fears, worries, and concerns. Without a doubt, there will be some fears, concerns, worries you have for the road ahead, whether it's your future and what the future lies ahead for you, whether or not it is the future that you want, whether it is even clarity. Maybe some of you are lacking clarity and you don't know what you're supposed to be doing or what your higher purpose in life is. In this case, do acknowledge that it's all right to be fearful, to be worried, to be concerned. If it also helps, write them down, what your fears, your worries, your concerns are. Look through them and think about these questions. Why am I worried about this? And what's the worst that could happen? And what can I do to manage the risks so that I feel safe going into the future? With these 3 questions, it will help you to both acknowledge your fears, worries, and concerns, but it will also help you plan a better risk management plan so that when you move ahead, you know that you have done all that is necessary to prepare for what is to happen. Tip number 3 is to take things slowly and methodically. For some of us, it may be the first time in 2, 3, 4 years that we last touch our resume, our cover letter, and honestly, with so many things happening going on at the same time, the grad trip, going for interviews and all that, it may get very, very overwhelming. And so the trick is to take things one day at a time, to plan out what you have to do today and just worry about doing it today. Tomorrow can worry about itself. If you're a good planner, you can plan a lot longer ahead, maybe 1 week, maybe a month ahead. But if you're just starting out, I'll say, take things one day at a time, slowly, methodically, you'll get there one day. Tip number 4 is to share your journey with somebody that cares. Our job search journey can be really, really lonely, and talking to somebody who doesn't quite understand what's going on or who isn't really willing to be with you on this journey can get very disheartening and discouraging at times. So if you have a friend who's along this journey with you whom you can share your struggles and your worries with, or if it's a parent or it's a mentor that you know that you can talk to, that would be so helpful for you because you can bounce off ideas, ask that person, does this sound right? What should I wear for my interview tomorrow? Does this look good? And trust me, that encouragement, that moral support will definitely help you make this entire experience a lot more palatable. And tip number 5 is to never give up. after a while, it may be very tiring to keep on sending resume after resume after resume and not get a response. And you might be wondering, what on earth am I doing wrong? Well, interviewing and employing and recruiting is a very emotional experience, both for you as well as for the recruiter. And sometimes the time may not be right, and that's why you have been passed over for this opportunity. But don't worry, there is something out there for you. So don't give up, but don't sit at home and just wait for something to drop on your lap. While you are waiting and searching and going for interviews and just waiting to hear back from people, also, remember to hustle on the side. What do I mean by hustle on the side? Means start doing small little things on the side. Try different things. Go and experience for yourself different industries if you can. And that will not only help to beef up your resume, it will help you take your mind off this entire job search process. It will also expose you to the experiences that you need that one day could be helpful to and meaningful to drive you to the career that you want to, that you feel called to. And I hope these 5 tips help you in making your job search process happier and more productive. If you have any questions, please feel free to DM me directly. I'll be happy to answer them. So I'll see you again next week. Bye!